We've had some discussion today about analytics, and I'd love to get a perspective from folks on the panel as to the extent to which some of that data is going to start becoming available and being made available, not necessarily publicly, but as a tool. For example, I'm an ad agency, and I want to be able to do some more contextually oriented advertising, or Google, Android, contextual advertising around location. Certainly the operators have some of that information. They've been somewhat reticent up to now to release that. But what are people's thoughts on that over the next year or two in terms of some of that data being made available and being a revenue opportunity even for the operators?
Hmm. Anybody have any particular thoughts on that?
I don't mind starting. I think this element in the overall mix will reveal itself gradually in the near future. Because what we're seeing is the distribution increase and the usage increase. And from that, suddenly the things that we log and the things that we learn from users' activity with these kinds of services is just piling up, becoming this undiscovered gold mine. So I don't think we're even aware as an industry to what exactly we can extract from the patterns and the logging data that's being piled up on our servers. I think as location-based advertising moves forward, there will be two areas of huge growth for value in these things. One would be the immediate snapshot. What can we learn about the user at this given moment, completely anonymously, without profiling or analyzing patterns, et cetera, but what do we know about a certain user right now because of the weather, the traffic, or their ETA to a destination, the type of their destination, other information coming from other sensors, and we've heard a lot about that from Nokia CDMA in the previous panel. So there's gonna be a combination of things available to us at a given moment that if we mix and match correctly, our ability to extract enormous value from that at a given moment, snapshot level, is very high. The other, of course, is that crowdsourced pile of patterns that teaches us where do people go, what are they looking for when they happen to be en route to a certain type of destination on weekdays, on weekends, when they're in their town, when they're in their county, when they're in another country, when they're driving, when they're walking, when they're using public transportation, when are they using public transportation? And again, to understand human behavior, and then hopefully with software, to return part of that knowledge into improving the lives and making and maybe affecting human behavior in a positive way. To say now that there's a tool that will reveal all that magic to you in a day would not be a responsible thing to say, but that value is building up. It is somewhere between the operators, us, and Google, I guess, and the likes of us and the likes of Google, I should say, and it will start to reveal itself in the near future when the opportunities to monetize based on that analysis will be higher.
Okay.
Yeah, I would say it's not a tools question. I mean, take the, you know, underlying pinnings of Oracle's 11G, you know, locator, spatial, and it, I mean, you can actually code all this. You can do it in 3D. You know, you can do 3D coding of things to where you can take the data in. The question is, to what value does it get out for the consumer? Because I think it's possible to use the data to do that, but how does it actually end up benefiting the business and the consumer? I mean, we'll just put both sides to it. Because you can't, you know, in the end, it can't be a one-way street. And I don't know, there's many elements that I think have to do with questions that we want to raise about whether tracking privacy, things like that, that would have to be addressed. It's not a technology question, I don't think. I think it's a policy question for whether those opportunities would be allowed.
Was that your question about who has access to the location of an individual, or more around big piles of data that get crunched into answers? Or
it was more around the piles of data that are being made available. And that's resident in different places. The operators have some of it. They've been rents to release that. But there's other areas where
The folks that are vertically integrated in this area, like, you know, the Apple is the best example. Maybe Google is also a pretty good example. The guys that are controlling the device space, but also the service side, have huge advantage in capitalizing on, you know, on these piles of data that that are available, since, you know, they control most of the data. They don't need, you know, the man in the middle to kind of, you know, be there and support them. So I think that in the early stages, those guys are going to kind of, you know, be able to run, you know, faster and do more in that space. I guess that then the rest of the industry will need to kind of, you know, find their ways to standardize and to, you know, catch up with the vertically integrated folks.
I would say people who have big piles of data are trying to monetize them, right? Are you visualizing that people that you should have access to this big pile? Most people have big piles of data are trying to figure out how to make money off of them right now, like mobile ad. They're not too worried about trying to make an interface for you to get access to them right now. There are people trying to figure out how to monetize these big pile of data in new and interesting ways.
Okay, there was another question.
Regarding indoor location, I guess to the Cisco gentleman, you mentioned the Natural History Museum and using Wi-Fi to determine your location. The UbiSense guy that presented during one of the fast pitches indicated that we need to go beyond Wi-Fi when you go to ultra wideband was the technology he's using. Yeah. And so what do you see the technology direction, the requirements, how are we going to solve indoor location as well as it's been solved outdoors?
So from a technology point of view, Wi-Fi is kind of ubiquitous, so it kind of sets a foundation of what can be done. Ultra wideband gives you much better granularity, but it has a big overhead cost of putting a whole new network in. I would say in the Wi-Fi bucket, things are going down the path of getting better accuracy with using wall information. People are starting to get very smarter about that. They're starting to do time of arrival in different, in addition to RSSI fingerprinting. They're trying to use time to get better indoor location. I think someone here, they're putting other things inside the access points now, GPS, you know, to make that better. So I kind of see the Wi-Fi camp going one direction. There is definitely an overlay camp of different technologies like ultra wideband. The problem with that is you don't have an ecosystem to build. I mean, you really have to be committed to doing it.
So it's going to be, I think that to solve the indoor problem, it's going to be a mesh of technologies. I'm not sure that one technology is going to provide you with the, you know, total coverage that you need. It's probably going to be, Wi-Fi is going to play a big role. I'm not sure about NFC personally, but, you know, maybe this is also part of the solution. Okay. I think that sensors will also play, you know, a very important role in that. Maybe also, you know, badge readers, you know, NFC, RFID, these kind of technologies. I think that we also will going to see part of that. Point-to-point technologies that will enable you to you know, decipher your proximity are also going to be very important. So I think it's a mesh of technologies. I think that eventually somebody will need to standardize this, you know, bunch of capabilities that you're going to have and decipher the analytics that are needed to actually, you know, do something that is, you know, broader and you know, applicable, you know, worldwide. But I'm not sure that one technology currently is you know, available that can actually, you know, pinpoint your, you know,
and I may add, location. It's not so much, the addition to being the, you know, the actual location technology of figuring out where you're at, the map is becoming a big problem.
Yeah,
it's one thing to tell me that you're over here. It's another thing to say, okay, now where do I get the map for this building?
Okay, we've actually come to the end of our allotted time now for this panel, just as we're getting into a really interesting conversation. So we're going to have to finish there, but I'd like the panel for contributing to such an interesting subject area and for coming up with the sort of ideas that we have. Because I think it shows that location awareness, we have really just scratched the surface, and there's lots and lots of things that we can now be playing with over the next few years. So I'd like to thank the panel for their contributions. Great, thank you.
All right, thank you very much, Robin.